Good morning. Let September 8 begin. Ah, thank God it's Sunday. Lord, we bless this day. Be glorified, Lord, in all that we do. In Jesus' name. Amen. Oh Lord, do not rebuke me. Oh Lord, do not rebuke me is the title. Let's read. I'm going to read King James. Because, you know, I've been trying to read Aramaic, but it's not that good, actually. I like King James better. Psalm of David, bring to remembrance. O Lord, rebuke me not in thy wrath, neither chasten me in thy hot displeasures. For thine arrows strike fast in me, thy hand pressed me sore. There is no soundness in my flesh because of thine anger, neither is there any rest in my bones because of my sin. For mine iniquities are gone over mine head, and heavy burden they are too heavy for me. My wounds stink and corrupt because of my foolishness. I am troubled. I am bowed down greatly. I go mourning all day long. For my loins are filled with loathsome disease, and there is no soundness to my flesh. I am feeble and sore broke. I have roared by reason of the disquietness of my heart. Lord, all my desire is before thee, and my groaning is not hid from thee. My heart panteth, my strength faileth me, as the light of mine eyes also gone from me. My lovers and my friends stand aloof from my sore, and my kinsmen stand afar. Wow. Daily gospel question. Number one. David expressed Psalm 38:1-2, seeking mercy rather than rebuke in times of wrath. How can we apply this posture of humility and repentance in our own lives when we face the consequence of our action? In what ways can we seek align ourselves with God's grace in process of healing? So, 1 and 2. Psalm of David, trying to bring to remembrance. This is one of those prayers that Psalm 38 is one of those major prayer of repentance or the praise of repentance. It was in Psalm 6, 32, 38, 51, 101, 131, 143 are the seven major repenting prayer, right? Mostly from David in Psalm. And so this one is the one of the seven major repentance prayer. Right? Fervent cry of repentance. Second, this is one of the two of how like certain burnt offering or major kind of ceremony, this was read. So Psalm 38 and Psalm 70. So it has a double function. But when you read verse 1 and 2, Lord, rebuke me not in thy wrath, neither chasten me in thy displeasure, for thine arrows strike fast in me, and thy hand presses me sore. So he is talking about how he's sorry. I'm sorry, God. I'm ashamed. Right? I'm ashamed. It's not about guilt per se. You know, the whole thing about Matthew Henry, you know, out of this verse he wrote, this is Matthew Henry's commentary. The guilt of sin is burdened to the whole creation, which groans under it. It will be burdened to the sinners themselves, and they were heavy laden under it. Burden ruin when it sinks them to hell. But I don't think King David felt guilty. He was more ashamed because he talks about shame more than guilt. He never says, I feel so guilty. He said, I am so ashamed. So this is a typical case of how the Western, you know, I just so simply put, the white people try to put guilt on the emotion where David didn't feel guilty. He just felt ashamed. And like, well, is it the same? No, it's totally different. He said, do not rebuke me. I'm ashamed. And then the fact that he brings that shame thing into the public and in major ceremonies that people read about King David's sinful act, right? God's arrow has struck me. And basically talking about sickness, David is going through. It's that my flesh is rotting. And so I don't know what it was, but it's the result of the crimes. For my crimes have passed above my head like the heavy cargo, and they are heavy to me. My wounds defile me, right? And I'm troubled. I bow down greatly. I'm agitated all day long. I walk in sadness because my ankles are filled with shaking and there's no peace for my flesh, right? Wow. So what do you do? What do you do? When you cannot really tell God, judge me or vindicate me, because then this is going to happen. You go to God in humility and repentance. Don't go to God and make excuses. Don't go to God and complain to God. I was just finishing up another book on Soren Kierkegaard and his understanding of my poetry and Chun Sang-byung poetry. It's interesting how Ryu Shiwa, the great poet, he's not a Christian, but he said, throughout the Bible, Jesus did a lot of miraculous healing the sick, even raised the dead. But he wasn't able to heal the complainers. Wow. How do you heal the complainers? The sin of complaining cannot be healed. It could only be healed by repentance. When you go to God in repentance and say, Lord, I'm so sorry. I complain. You know. And one of the poem I wrote, wow, was about this guy that I met in Siberia. And after 7 years of meeting him, I had to finally release from my list of disciples. I mean, he complained when he came to my school about, oh, the school is so difficult. And when I sent him to Siberia to church planting, he said, oh, my wife is not pregnant and it's hard to get respected, you know, because it's considered cursed, no child. But we prayed and now she gave a birth and said, oh, but my village is too small. So we move him to a city. Oh, the city's too big. And this and that. 7 years. Every time we met, twice a year. Complain. Finally, after 7 years, I said, you know what? Just go your way. What are you going to do? Like, if Jesus cannot heal you, you know, unless you repent of the sin of constantly complaining. You know, you're going to complain when God shows up. Why are you so bright? You know, so helplessly. Yeah. So pray, Lord, do not rebuke me, because I'm going to repent. The whole posture of humility and repentance is what we need when we go through this issue. And when you're found out, and you've been found out of your evil deeds, well, immediately go to your knees and repent. Don't try to make excuses. Don't try to cover it up. Don't try to make, you know, when you did something evil to somebody, oh, just go and apologize, ask for forgiveness. You know, don't try to cover, don't try to justify, like, oh, but you know, because you did this, you know, I did that. I'm just bullshit. You know, it's just like, oh, shut up. Just deep inside, you know, you've done something wrong. Then just go and no excuses. Like, I'm so sorry. You know, please forgive me. That's it. You know, God will not rebuke you. God will not throw that arrow at you. You know, amen. So do not rebuke me in your wrath, neither discipline me in your anger, O God. Yes, Lord, we repent before you. We've done wrong. We're not going to make excuses or complain about the circumstance. Help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord bless you. See you tomorrow.